federal health authorities have added 58 types of cancer to the list of World Trade Center related illnesses covered by the Zadroga Act. It sets aside nearly 2.8 billion.
Thank you.
How important is it, this classification, that these cancers, these 50-some cancers, are now included? How important is this for first responders, and how many people will it help?
Well, this was a very significant toxic. Yes, just think about when you want to dispose of a computer.
The goal was search and rescue and just getting a fire out and the job done. No one was thinking about the longer term impact. And I think that most of the people, if not all of them down there, would have done exactly what they did, knowing that there was a risk to themselves.
Absolutely.
When the outcome for some people, which is cancer, asthma, all kinds of respiratory illnesses. But there's also, you know, you scar the lungs, you can scar the heart too, and the psyche. There are people who, obviously, you guys are seeing and treating for just the fallout 11 years later of what they saw and endured that day. There's $4 billion a little over in the program. Are any of the concerns that as you are adding more people to the class of people who may develop cancers later, is this money going to last? Is there going to be enough money for people?
Well, we hope.
Check in with you on that angle of the story, too. Dr. Benjamin Left, the World Trade Center. In about 45 minutes, we're talking to New York City.
Asking you in the break, I mean, you know, what are we expecting today?
Yeah,
what do you think we're going to...
This is like the Super Bowl of earnings reports, because everyone who covers this stuff wants to know just how much money J.P. Morgan Chase lost on this rogue trade. They got so much attention. How could the smartest banker in the industry, the huge bank J.P. Morgan Chase, how could they just have a trading loss that would balloon from $2 billion to $3 billion, maybe even more? We're going to see somebody who's, you know, one of the biggest bankers out there. I want to know about the effects of the Europe downturn and what they're seeing there in terms of their business and what's happening in the banking industry, because that's incredibly important to the stability of the financial system.
Really? Even more so than this massive loss?
This is a massive loss, but let me tell you something. You know, whether it's $2 billion or $5
billion or $9
billion, the company made $19 billion in profit last year.
Wow.
That trade in and of itself is not going to take this company down. Mm. It is embarrassing. It is stupid. It is something that is... He says they're going to be stronger for it. J.P. Morgan does. J.P. Morgan Chase, Jamie Dimon says. But, you know, that trading loss in and of itself is not going to take that company.
The impact is far greater in what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Beyond the numbers, it's really an image cleanup.
Absolutely. Absolutely. This
well.
Is the this is a PR yeah. nightmare worth way more than $5 billion.
And how about contrition on Capitol Hill? Who'd have thunk? Christine Romans.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
One wrong. Christine Romans is our resident expert.
Yeah,
and we're talking
that.
A pretty big window, aren't we?
We are, and I want to tell you sort of what happened here. We learned about this $2 billion trading loss earlier this year, actually in the beginning of May. And, you know, $2 billion is an... We'll find out what's happened further to the risk management of this bank to make sure it never happens again. We'll probably find out if there are any kind of layoffs at the company, further layoffs for other reasons. We're going to find out what the impact is of the Eurozone and its banking and financial crisis. There's a lot to go through. This is a humongous bank, and Jamie Dimon is going to be sitting in a room with a bunch of analysts, and I mean, my guidance is that this thing, we're going to get the earnings at 7. It's going to meet with analysts at 7:30. This thing could be going on well into... I think that's why you're going to see him answering every single question from these analysts. He's going to say, the buck stops with me, so what do you want to know, guys?
Transparency.
He's going to try to show some transparency there overall.
What's the one thing we need to know about our money today?
All right, the one thing you need to know about your money today, mortgage rates, record lows again. The 30-year fixed rate, ladies and gentlemen, drum roll please, 3.56%. Let me say that again. 3.56%. The 15-year fixed rate, 2.86%.
No.
Every time I tell you this, people go, I can't get the loan.
Is it time to refinance again?
Maybe.
I mean, it's worth it, isn't it? If you refinance in December.
3.65.
No, not yet.
Okay.
I'll let you know.
Okay.
That's a great question. You got to do the math yourself, but... if rates keep falling like this, I mean, 3.5% for 30-year
fixed. I went from 4.25 to 3.65, and I figured out that I would recoup in less than a year, so
wow.
It was worth it for me.
Great.
So, yeah.
2.86 for
50. I remember getting 5.25 and thinking I was
nabbing
the
in
deal
the money.
Of a lifetime.
That's right.
Yeah. I got a deal for you.
2 points ago.
Yeah, that was then. That was 8.
All right, starting point less than a minute away. We wrap it up, as always, with best advice.
And today, that best advice comes from our own Ashley Banfield. It's her last morning waking up with us.
I know. I'm very sad to be leaving you, but very excited about doing 11 a.m. on CNN. So here's my best advice. It starts with my mom's best advice. Make sure you prepared when the luck strikes, because that's kind of how this... Read. Never stop. Start when you can start. First grade, and never stop. Read everything you can.
I always say over-prepare and then go with the flow.
True.
Oh, yeah. Can I tell you I'm over-preparing right now, because I'm waiting. First quarter earnings will be restated. We've been waiting for the second quarter, so... in the next few minutes, I'm going to have some more news for you about J.P. Morgan, but that's they're restating their first quarter.
You bring me to my third point of best advice, and that is love you. You love your work.
Tony Bennett said that once to me, 80-some odd years strong, and yeah, he said, I've never worked a day in my life.
We're in the newsroom, and all we ever talk about is like
hoping that we'll be able to do a lot of fun business stuff and a lot of fun news stuff at 11 o'clock. When you start, that starts Monday?
It's a guarantee. I got the kids, and we're about to head to the airport.
A lot of people don't know. You know this. Ashley and I have known each other for
12 years now.
Longer.
Going on 13 now.
It's been a long time.
Back in your anyway, love you.
Oh, so it's the last chance I get to say that's early start. Oh. The news from A to Z, but today it's the news from A to Cho. I'm Ashley Banfield. It's been a thrill to be with you every morning.
And we're going to miss you on the early morning show. I'm Melina Cho. Starting Point with Soledad O'Brien starts right now.